So, hello everyone and welcome to the channel. This is the part 7 of the Unreal Engine Beginner series, and in this video we're going to talk about BSPs inside of Unreal Engine 4. So BSP stands for binary space partitioning in Unreal Engine 4, and BSPs are really useful to, you know, mock up a level design really quickly, and they're not really used to make the entire final level, but they are used to just get the right shape, and then you can use static meshes to replace the BSPs. So how do we work with BSPs then? So in the place actors panel right here, you need to go to geometry, and then you can see these 7 brushes right here. Now, due to some reason, if you don't have the place actors panel opened up, then you can go to window and place actors right there. So go to the geometry tab, and then you'll see these 7 brushes along with these 2 add and subtract options. So we're not gonna worry about them just yet. I'll tell you them later in this video only. So let's just place one of these into our scene. The most basic one you can get is of course the cube, or you can say the box. And also one more thing you may notice while placing this, if I just undo this real quick. While placing this, it first shows you an outline and then renders the entire shape. The same goes with the transformation tools, the rotate tool, the scale tool, the move tool, all the transformation tools as well, as you can see like that. So the reason actually that's happening is because when you, for example, when you move on this BSP, then all of the faces, the vertices and the edges are moved, and when you release your mouse button, then the BSP is re-rendered according to the edges and, you know, vertices, faces. That's the reason, according to me. Alright, so we have this box brush right here. Now, of course, you may not want a box. We want to edit some of its properties, you know, just play with its shape. So, if you want to actually edit the brush settings, you have to go to the details panel, of course, and you can get all of the brush settings for this brush under the brush settings section right here. You can also show advanced and get all of these options. We're not going to worry about them just yet. So let's talk about the brush type first, the additive and subtractive world types. Additive adds to other BSPs and subtractive subtracts from other BSPs. So additive is actually pretty clear. If you just drag another BSP in here, both are additive. Yeah, that's pretty good. They are just adding to the environment. But what if we add a box in subtractive mode? Yes, now it does not really show up. If we deselect it, then the outlines also don't show up. But if we move it inside our initial box, see what happens? See what I mean? It subtracts from other BSPs. It does not subtract from static meshes though. So if I just try putting it here, it does not subtract. But it subtracts from other BSPs. So basically the area it covers, it subtracts from other BSPs. So the area that is overlapping between this BSP and this BSP, they two, both of them are being subtracted, and the subtractive brush type is subtracting from the initial BSP, if that makes any sense to you. But you can just see kind of like how it works and all. So the reason is really useful is if I just delete the subtractive brush type and make a wall out of this. I know a wall, I'll just make. Alright, that looks like a wall. And let's drag a box in here and give it a shape of a door. Just like that. Now if you place it in here, nothing happens, but let's do it to subtractive. As you can see, it's a doorway. It's a doorway and we have a doorway. So that can be actually really useful by mocking you up your levels. So that's why subtractive brush types are really useful. Now you may always, you may not always just want to just change it from here. You can also select subtractive from here, and when you make a brush, it will always be subtractive. Let's do to additive for now. I'll delete both of these and start over again with a new box brush. Now, another thing to keep in mind with the subtractive brush type is, for example, if I make another subtractive brush here, this time with this subtractive mode toggle, I mean, that subtracts from it. But if I drag another one of these boxes in here, it does not subtract from this box, right? Yeah, why is that? I got no clue about that, but it does not work like this. The subtractive brush type has to be placed after all of the brushes you want to subtract from. As you can see, if I refresh this like this, then also it does not work. But if I drag a new box brush, of course, in the subtractive brush type, then as you can see, it subtracts with both of those. So that's kind of a disadvantage. So you can just cope up with that, I guess. So let's drag a new cube here. Now the brush shape, there are 7 brush shapes available here, and notice that there's no sphere in here, and instead of that there's a tetrahedron. And if you select it, then it will show up as a sphere, but it's technically a tetrahedron. But if you increase the tessellation, then yeah, obviously it looks like a sphere. So I guess it makes sense. So there are many other things you can actually try, like these stairs and linear stairs and all. For now, we are going to stick with the cube. Alright, so now we know that about these two things. Now the other things, before talking about them, I will show you how to apply materials to a brush. It's pretty different. It's basically the same thing, but it's still different. So I have this texture from the previous video, which we imported into the content browser. And I also have a material. And if you're wondering how did I create a material, you can just drag one of these in and it will just create a material for you. Or you can just right click and create material right here. So I'll just use this material directly. I'll just place it here. And as you can see, it does not place it on the entire BSP. It places it on a face of the BSP. Oh no, sorry for that. Okay, now we have almost all of the BSP covered except the down face. Yeah, that does not tile really good, but still there's a texture on it, so it's good. So that's how we actually apply a material on a box brush or any other brushes right here. But sometimes it can get annoying. For example, let's get the spiral stairs. Deselect the material, get the spiral stairs. They have the default material on the void grid material. Now you have to apply it on like each and every segment in here, like every single step. That can be really annoying. So what can you do is you can select the material you want to be applied to the whole brush, and then drag the brush, and it will be applied to each and every face of the brush. Really useful tip and really handy to know. And you can actually still replace the textures at any time you want. Now let's actually drag another box in here. Now let's talk about the properties of each and every individual face. So if I select this face right here from the viewport, then we can see our details panel just changed. A lot more options than we previously had. So these all options are just for the UVs. So if we can actually rotate the UVs, and this checker pattern really represents how the UVs should be. So you can rotate the textures, you can rotate the UVs. If I rotate the texture, as you can see, it just rotates 90 degrees and 45 degrees too. As you can see, it rotated 45 degrees. You want to flip it. And of course you can scale it too. But the thing with scaling is that you have to just click on this apply button right here. As you can see, our squares are way more smaller now. But this does not apply to each and every face of the BSP, and only on one face of the BSP. Alright, so we know how to do that now. Let's get rid of the BSP. Okay, so now I actually want to say you something about the disadvantage of BSP, and then after I'm gonna say you how to fix it. So, for example, let's just get a spiral stairs. And we edit it a bit, like, you know, add a bit of textures on it, a material, maybe right there, right over there, right over there. We're really happy with this stair, for example, and we just want to convert this to a static mesh. We can definitely do that. But why convert this to a static mesh? Well, that's the disadvantage of BSPs. So while using BSPs, I mean, it's good for mocking up a level, but if you use it for a final level, then it's gonna suck. It's really gonna suck. Your performance will be heavily reduced and your frame rate will die. So BSPs are not really good performance stuff. I mean, they do not really affect performance that much, but I mean, small things matter sometimes. Okay, so now let's see how to convert this brush into a static mesh. And which can, now converting this brush to a static mesh can really stop that, but the quality will not be really good. So I really recommend using something like Maya or something to you know, get the final product. So to create a static mesh, you just go in the brush settings right here by selecting the brush. Make sure a face is not selected. The entire brush should be selected, something like this. And you can create a static mesh simply like this. Then you have to select a path. Let's select the meshes folder. Right there. So we have our spiral stair brush static mesh right here. And here also our brush is replaced with the static mesh actor. Okay, that's really cool. So that's how you actually use BSPs inside your scene. And also share your artwork in my Discord right there. If you just create something with BSPs, mock up your level or something, then you can definitely share in the Discord. A link is in the description box below. So I hope you liked the video. If you enjoyed the video, if you learned something new today, then please do subscribe to the channel and see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.